बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, वेलकम अगेन इन अ वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम ऑफ पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ, किंगडम ऑफ सऊदी अरेबिया। एज यू नो दैट दिस इज पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ ऑनलाइन क्लास फॉर क्लास 9 स्टूडेंट, सब्जेक्ट इज कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड दिस इज आवर 16 लेक्चर और 16 वीडियो एंड द टीचर नेम इज इमरान अहमद। Keep in mind the Zoom meeting ID 3326299208 for any queries to contact me on this time and these days. In the previous lecture, we were discussing the chapter number 5, which is computer network. So already we have done the first 10 short questions and I think 4 long questions. Today we will further do the next questions, which are, before starting our new topic, just feedback of our previous topics or previous lectures. First short question was, describe any 3 difficulties a company may face in running a business without having a computer network. Second question was, what is meant by data transmission? Third question was, differentiate between half duplex and full duplex transmission modes. And fourth question, define network architecture. Next question, differentiate between server and client computer. After this, there was a question, compare LAN and WAN, local area network and wide area network. So we skipped the 2 short questions. Why star topology is more reliable than bus or ring topologies today? If we have time, we will discuss this question also, as well as this one. Mention any 3 problems which may occur if peer-to-peer network is used for large number of users in an organization. But first, we will complete our topic, which is mesh topology. We will coming to that question. After this one, next short question, what is ISDN? Last short question was, what is CDMA technology? After this, we have completed the short question. We'll move further to the long questions. And the first long question was, what are the advantages of using networks? So this was the diagram of network I show you. Then the advantages of network. In the advantages, we have discussed hardware sharing, software sharing, file sharing, and internet sharing. Second long question was, describe client or server and peer-to-peer networks. Over here, first we'll discuss the client-server network and then characteristics of client-server network, and then the diagram of this client-server network. After this, we have completed the client-server. We come to the peer-to-peer network. Over here, we will discuss the properties and peer-to-peer diagram. Third question was, describe the types of network based on the area covered. So over here we have discussed already 3 types, which are local area network, wide area network, and metropolitan area network. This is diagram belongs to the local area network, then wide area network. After this, we have completed the wide area network, then we will move to the metropolitan area network. This diagram represents the metropolitan area network. This question, explain the types of network topology. We were discussing that network topology, physical arrangement of devices in a network is called network topology. Already we have discussed the first 3 topologies, bus topology, ring topology, star topology. Over here, bus topology, watch here a diagram. If you understand the diagram, you can easily describe the bus topology. Its merits means advantages, demerits means limitations of bus topology. Already we have discussed a lot about this topic. Then ring topology, over here, if you understand the diagram, then you can describe the ring topology very easily, and advantages of ring topology and limitations of ring topology. Next was last topic, or last in the last class we have discussed the star topology, which is very, very important topology. Over here we use a special device which is called switch or hub. So this diagram, so if you know or if you understand this diagram, so you can easily define the star topology, its merits and its demerits, means limitations of star topology. You can eat. Today our topic is mesh topology. Mesh topology, watch over the diagram over here. This is the diagram of mesh topology. This, if I remove the stars between that, so it will make the ring topology. But in the ring topology, each and every computer are connected to the forward as well as backward computer. So over here in the mesh topology, each and every computer is connected to another computers, all other computers. For example, this is the computer number one, this is node number two, this is three, this is four, and this is five. So if I take this computer, watch here, it is connected to computer number two, as well as computer number five, as well as computer number four, as well as computer number three. So each, I explain this one, node two, this computer is also connected to computer one, computer three, computer four with this line, and computer five with this line. So it means that we can say that in mesh topology, each and every computer is connected to another computer in a network. So it makes a mesh topology. Its definition, in mesh topology, all nodes are connecting to each other. All nodes are connecting to each other means, watch here, this is the computer and this one is connected to all other computers. So this one is connected to all other computers. It is not common. Message sent on mesh network can take any possible path from source to destination. Now, message paths. For example, in the ring topology, if this computer, I am talking about the ring topology, if this computer want to send the data to this one, it means that node one send data to node four. So first it comes to the node two, then node three, then node four. So this one is make the ring. But over here in the mesh topology, what happened? It is fast. Why? Because it has the direct connection to the computer number four. So computer number one or node number one easily send using this path to send the message or data to the node number four. So in this way, all computers can communicate very easily and select the best path if they are. For example, this one is broken, then it will send the data like this one. So any possible destination can be sent. Over here, message sent on a mesh network can take any possible path from source to destination. Remember, keep in mind, source is that computer which want to send the data, and destination is that computer which want to accept the data, is called destination of computer. It is not commonly used since it is costly. Why it is not commonly used? Watch over here. Because every computer, let's say you have computer number one and you need four cables to connect all other devices. Watch here, this is computer number one, and you want to connect this one computer, also this one, also this one, also this one. So it is not commonly used. Star topology is most commonly used, but this topology is although exists, but not commonly used in any organization. It is not commonly used since it is costly and difficult to implement. Difficult, why I am talking about to difficult to implement. Let's say if any other computer number six want to join this network, then what happened? All other computers can be connected with that one also. So extra cables are needed to connect that computers to make a mesh topology. What are the advantages of mesh topology? Mesh topology advantages. It is the most reliable network topology because alternative paths are available in case a path is broken from source to destination. I am talking, as I told you, that if let's say this computer want to connect the data, want to send the data to node number 4, and this cable is not working at the moment, then what happened? It means that this computer cannot send the data. No, it can send the data to this computer through which destination? So next possible destination is from node number 5 to node number 4, or node number 3 to node number 4, or node number 2 to node number 4. So any possible destination or any possible path it can choose and deliver the data. So this is the most reliable network, but its limitations are very, very. So first one, most expensive topology to implement since it's require more cable. Why? Then bus. In bus, a single cable is used over here. A 5 computer network, you at least you have the 4 cable. More cable than bus, ring or star topologies. So I explained the bus topology, ring topology, and star topology. So this one is very difficult to implement. Number 2, difficult to implement as compared to other topologies. Difficult to implement, as I told you, if the computer or node number 6 want to join this network, so how can he join the network? He also needed the 5 cables to join this network. Why I'm talking to 5 cable? Because he want to connect with this one as well as that one, this one and this one, up to so on. So this will make the mesh topology difficult to implement as compared to other topology. Next drawback or next limitation is difficult to add new computer. You can add, but difficult to add new computer. So these are the topologies which we have discussed in our lecture. So this is the mesh topology. Over here we have discussed in the topologies very, very important topic. So in the examination they can give you in a short question, as I told you, they can break this question into single part. For example, they can ask, explain the mesh topology. So on that time you can explain only mesh topology and it can be a short question. But if it is present in the long question, so you will explain all of the topologies. This is our topic, topologies. Our next question is, write a note on dial-up and DSL internet connection. So first one is dial-up connection and second is DSL internet connection. Dial-up already we have discussed in our short questions, but over here, because it is present in the long question, we will also explain over here. Dial-up line uses standard telephone lines. If you have the telephone, for example, you have the STC connection, not a mobile connection, STC not mobile SIM, STC phone line connection, then you can use this one. Dial-up line uses standard telephone lines for internet connection. It requires a dial-up modem. So I show you before, dial-up modem is, there are two types of modem, dial-up modems are, one is internal modem, second one is external modem, and internal modem, the wireless modem is also over there. So dial-up modem, it requires a dial-up modem that provides a maximum internet connection speed of how much? Watch over here. Over here, the most important thing is 56 kilobits per second. 56,000 bits per second, you can say that. 56,000 bits per second. So in 1 second, you can download speed or uploading speed is how much? 56 kilobits per second, which is very, very low. It means that if you have this connection at your home and you want to open any single picture, it will take your 5 to 10 minutes for downloading or for viewing a single picture. So this one is very, very slow speed internet connection. It is becoming outdated. Outdated means nowadays no one is used. why no one is used this internet connection due to very slow internet connection. As I told you, if you want to see a single picture on internet, or if you want to see any video, so it is not possible to watch the video, complete video on dial-up connection, because it will require your hours and hours. But over here I am talking about if you want to see a single picture, so after a 5 to 10 minutes, it will take to 5 to 10 minutes to download at your mobile or at your computer. So this one is dial-up modem. Next one is DSL. DSL nowadays, yeah, we have using commonly at our homes. So DSL stand for digital subscriber line. DSL stand for digital subscriber line. Provides a very high speed broadband internet connection. High speed broadband internet connection. So it is, as compared to dial-up, DSL is very high speed. It is called broadband. Any type of internet speed that is 256 kilobits per second or above is known as broadband. What is broadband? So any internet connection which is above than 256 kilobits per second, it means that, watch over here, dial-up have the speed of 56 kilobits per second, and over here it is 256 kilobits per second. It means that if you are using above then, if you are using internet at your home and its connect, its speed limit is above that 256 kilobits per second, you can say that I have broadband connection. So DSL is a broadband connection. A DSL modem is required for setting up the DSL internet connection. When you have purchased, so you must set up at your home. It means that you will call some person to install these things and the DSL modem at your home, so you can use easily. Internet service providers, ISPs. ISPs, who are the ISPs? Let's say in Saudi, in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, STC is, you can say they're STC, they're ISP. Zen, they're ISP. Mobile, they are ISP, and other companies are also exist, but most familiar are the Zen, Mobile, and STC are the ISPs. Internet service provider. Why I'm calling this one, are they are the ISP? Because they provide us the internet. That's why we call the internet service providers. Have several DSL speed available with a different monthly rate. Different monthly rate, for example, you are paying the 200 SR Saudi riyal, so or 300 Saudi riyal, as compared to 300 or 200 is a little bit slower. Or you can say that if you have the STC connection and it's 10 MB means it is more than 256 kilobytes per second. So for 10 MB, they are charging, for, let's say they are charging 200 Saudi riyal. And for 20 or 50 MB, they are, let's say, charging 300 Saudi riyal. So it depends on the monthly rates, what you are paying. So this one is known as the DSL. Inshallah, tomorrow we will discuss over here, our all the short questions and long questions are completed. I remember our two short questions are still remaining. Tomorrow, inshallah, we will discuss the short questions, remaining short questions, and the MCQs which are present in your books. So till then, take care and Allah Hafiz.